Hello world. I'm Imagination. Today I'm going to talk about nanobots. Nanorobotics is an emerging technology field creating machines or robots whose components are at or near the scale of a nanometer. The terms nanobot, nanoid, nanite, nanomachine, or nanomite have also been used to describe such devices currently under research and development. Nanomachines are largely in the research and development phase, but some primitive molecular machines and nanomotors have been tested. An example is a sensor having a switch approximately 1.5 nanometers across, able to count specific molecules in the chemical sample. Most historians credit the concept of nanotechnology to physicist Richard Feynman in his 1959 speech, "There's Plenty of Room at the Bottom." In his speech, Feynman imagined a day when machines could be miniaturized and huge amounts of information could be encoded in minuscule spaces, paving the way for disruptive technological developments. Drexler posited the idea of self-replicating nanomachines, machines that build other machines. Because these machines are also programmable, they can then be directed to build not only more of themselves, but also more of whatever else you'd like. And because this building takes place on an atomic scale, these nanobots can pull apart any kind of material, soil, water, air, you name it, atom by atom, and construct, well, just about anything. Drexler painted the picture of a world where the entire Library of Congress could fit on a chip the size of a sugar cube and where environmental scrubbers could clear pollutants from the air. In the same ways that technology research and development drove the space race and nuclear arms race, a race for nanorobots is occurring. There is plenty of ground allowing nanorobots to be included among the emerging technologies. Nanofactory Collaboration, founded by Robert Freitas and Ralph Merkel in 2000 and involving 23 researchers from 10 organizations and 4 countries, focuses on developing a practical research agenda specifically aimed at developing positionally controlled diamond mechanosynthesis and a diamond-doed nanofactory that would have the capability of building diamond-doed medical nanorobots. Retroviruses can be retrained to attach to cells and replace DNA. They go through a process called reverse transcription to deliver genetic packaging in a vector. Potential uses for nanorobotics in medicine include early diagnosis and targeted drug delivery for cancer, biomedical instrumentation, surgery, pharmacokinetics, monitoring of diabetes, and healthcare. In such plans, future medical nanotechnology is expected to employ nanorobots injected into the patient to perform work at a cellular level. Such nanorobots intended for use in medicine should be non-replicating, as replication would needlessly increase device complexity, reduce reliability, and interfere with the medical mission. Nanotechnology provides a wide range of new technologies for developing customized means to optimize the delivery of pharmaceutical drugs. Today, harmful side effects of treatments such as chemotherapy are commonly a result of drug delivery methods that don't pinpoint their intended target cells accurately. Imagine going to the doctor to get treatment for persistent fever. Instead of giving you a pill or a shot, the doctor refers you to a special medical team that implants a tiny robot into your bloodstream. The robot detects the cause of your fever, travels to the appropriate system, and provides a dose of medication directly to the infected area. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.